As we are going to learn prior to the adoption of agriculture, in this module, we'll be looking at how the early man adopted the agriculture. People had gathered plant produce as a source of food. So the main source of food for the early man was the plant produce. Slowly, they learned more about the different kinds of plants. Gradually, the early man started to understand the different kinds of plants, where they grew, in which climatic conditions they grew, which area they grew, what kind of soil they grew. May not be knowing all the technical terms in reality, but he might be observing when this particular plant will bore a fruit and so on. So, prior to the adoption of agriculture, the people had gathered plant produce as a source of food. Slowly and gradually, they learned more about the different kinds of plants, where they grew, the seasons, when they bore fruit, and so on. So they started to observe the different kinds of plants and at what time, in which season, they bore fruits and so on. From this, they learned to grow plants. After observing the plants, they started to learn how to grow the plants. In West Asia, wheat, barley, pears, and various kinds of pulses were grown, while in the East and Southeast Asia, the crops that grew steadily were millets and rice. Millets was also grown in Africa. After observing the plants, in which season they grew and when they bore the fruits, man learned to grow plants. In West Asia, the crops which were grown were wheat, barley, different kinds of pulses, and pears. While in the East and the Southeast Asia, the millets and rice were predominantly grown. Millets were also grown in Africa as well. These developments led to other changes in their lifestyle. When people grew crops, they had to stay in the same place till the crops got ripened. So the major change that has come due to the practice of agriculture was when people grew crops, they have to stay at the same place or places nearby where they are cultivating the crops till the crops got ripened. So, this gradually led to settled life that became more common. And with that, people built more permanent structures in which to live. So, with the practice of agriculture that made people to stay in the same place till the crops got ripened, so it led them to settle at a particular place. As they have to settle down and live, they started to build more permanent structures in which to live. The way stone tools were made also changed. The second major change was the making of the stone tools. Earlier methods of making tools continued. At the same time, some tools and equipment were now smoothened, made smooth and polished by an elaborate process of grinding it. So earlier the tools were not smoothened nor polished. So now, in order to use them effectively, they started to smoothen them and polish them through an elaborate process of grinding. A new equipment included mortars, pestles for processing and grinding the grain, as well as stone axes, hoes, which were used to clear land for cultivation, as well as for digging the earth to sow the seeds. So they started to make new stone tools, make further process and make them easy for doing cultivation. So that's all we have in this module. So in this module, we learned how, prior to the adoption of agriculture, what was the main source of food for the people. Then, what are the major crops that were grown in West Asia, East and Southeast Asia, as well as in Africa. The developments which led them to live a settled life, and also the change in the stone tools are the major things what we learned in this module. Stay tuned, we'll catch you in the next.